Hi, welcome to my free Java video course, Lesson 3. My name is Markus Biel. I'm a software craftsman with 14 years of experience in Java. Debriefing. For debriefing, we will go back to our development environment and have a look what we learned so far. Okay, now we're back in our development environment. And now let's repeat what we learned so far. The first line of our program is the package declaration. It must be unique and it usually consists of your domain name in reverse order. So in my case, com, Markus Biel, Java course, lesson 2. And we end it with a colon. Actually, it's not mandatory. It's optional, but please, I really recommend you to use a package name. Later on, you will probably see why. You just need to have some practice, but for now, just believe me, treat this as if it was mandatory and always define a package name. After the package declaration, we can have one or more import statements. This, just for our lesson now, I made up. I created a new class called name, and this is in a sub-package called lesson 3. Actually, all classes that are in the same package, so person is in the package com Markus Biel Java course lesson 2, for all classes that are in the exactly same package, lesson 2 at the end, we don't need to import them. Java will find them automatically. But here I made this lesson 3, so if we want to use the name class that I just wrote, we have to import it. Okay, next thing is class definition, public class person. And with these brackets, this says the class begins, this says the class ends. Public means all other classes, for example, my new class name. In any package can see the class person. What this can see means is still a bit vague. For now, just take it as it is. I don't expect you to fully understand it yet. This will need some practice. And here, for now, some new stuff. I added the class that I defined, name. And I made it private, which is also best practice to have. We call this a reference variable because it is a reference to later on an object of type name. And I made it private, which means other objects that get created will not be able to see or access this field here directly. If they want to use it, they have to go using this method I also just created. This one is public and it returns person name. So when they call person.name, the method, you can give it any name, I just called it so, but you could also call it, I don't know, return the name. So this can be anything, and it will return the person name. So here again we see return, which means I want this to be returned to whoever calls that method, and the colon, which means do it, execute it. Okay, what else did we learn? We learned that this is a string, and that having a class returning hello world is like a running gag in programming for the first program that you do. So this is why I made class person return hello world. I mean, actually it might not make sense, but yeah, just was all made up. Then also, going to the test, we learned we actually start with writing a test. When we wrote the test, we hadn't defined the class person yet, We hadn't defined the method hello world yet. We did all this on the fly, and our development environment assisted us with some auto-completion. It was able to create the class as well as the method. So this is really a handy way of programming. First of all, you define the test. So this gives you an opportunity to think about a proper design. And then you define what you need, and you don't have to actually even write it yourself. And when you did everything correctly, you can simply execute the test, and when it returns okay and it's green, you will see that you did a proper job. Okay, see? Here you see a green bar, which means the test executed successfully. So when testing, we often speak of green or red bar, because the green bar is such a good signal that you understand your test passed successfully, that people got used to just speak of green and red bars. Okay, so we learned some more stuff. For example, that this is an annotation, and I told you, you don't need to know more details about it yet. We'll go into details later. Besides, I talked of import static, and also I just want you for now to know that something static exists, but we'll go into details later. Okay, I think that's it. It's okay if you don't understand everything perfectly yet. I don't expect you to. So we'll go in more details later. And we'll repeat all the stuff. So it's fine. I mean, the start is really tough. I know that. I don't expect you to be an expert in Java yet. This is just an introduction, and you will grasp it soon. So thanks for watching. Hope to see you next time. And please send feedback to info@marcus-biel.com.